So Erik ten Hag's Manchester United era in the Premier League starts with a defeat against Brighton at Old Trafford. Who knew that going into a Premier League season with no fit striker would hurt Man United? Who knew that going into a Premier League season and starting Fred and McTominay together in midfield would hurt Manchester United? And it did, and the quality was not there at all today. In that first half, we have, what, a good opening 5 minutes? But everything positive that we saw from that preseason, we didn't see today. We didn't see any overlapping runs, really, from the fullbacks. Short and DeLow, pretty woeful. We didn't see any build-up play through the middle. Every single time that our centre-backs had the ball, Scott McTominay was basically hiding, invisible. He's nowhere near good enough to start in that midfield for Manchester United. And you can see exactly why Ten Hag needs De Jong. We need more quality. That team there, those players there, they're not good enough overall for what this system is. And as I said, and I'm firmly looking at Scott McTominay here, it's just not good enough at all. And it's a terrible start. It really is a terrible start. Every single time, you could say that Harry Maguire was flat-footed. Yes, he was, but the midfield wasn't there. Everything that we saw in the preseason, all around our overlapping fullbacks, creating cutbacks. Geez, you could count on one hand how many crosses we sent in during the preseason. It was all about cutbacks. Today, it was just aimless crosses into the box whenever we got near it. Brighton, a good team, well-drilled team. Yeah, cool. Right. But Manchester United, absolutely woeful today. No intensity at all, apart from that opening 5 to 6 minutes. Hardly won the ball high up the pitch. The press wasn't there. As I say, like Erik ten Hag needs more. And we've given him Farrell, Malacia. Yeah, I personally thought he should have started today. And Shaw's performance showed me exactly why. We need De Jong. We need De Jong. We need more. That whole midfield today was just... The setup was bad. The setup was poor. I didn't really particularly like the idea of seeing Christian Eriksen starting as the number nine, but we didn't have anybody else there. So Erik ten Hag decided to go for him. I thought that Bruno Fernandes would operate as a false nine. But anyway, going into a season with no fit, recognised striker, who knew that it would hurt us? Danny Welbeck looked like he should... My God. It's the preparation for the season, man. Pre-season, as I said, there were so many positives to take from it. And today, it all just collapsed. Everything that we saw just wasn't there. It was the polar opposite. The quality was just nowhere near. When Ronaldo came on, I'd say the shape of United changed. Playing with a striker changed it, and it improved it. Eriksen was able to drop a little bit deeper, and we were able to play away from Scott McTominay. I want to keep going back to that. I think McTominay can have a position in the squad. He's a squad midfielder. He should not be starting every week for Manchester United. Fred had a really poor game as well. The whole midfield did. Everybody did. There's not somebody I would say that really stood out in that. Martinez was okay. DeLow and Shaw, woeful. Sancho hardly had the ball. Hardly got the ball to our most dangerous player in the whole preseason. And Marcus Rashford's finishing. Jeez. What was that about? How did he not score from that cutback from Ronaldo? Insane. But look, Erik ten Hag, I have utter belief that if he gets what he needs, this system can work and Manchester United can head in the right direction. We've seen all the patterns are there in the preseason. Everything is right there. And it wasn't there today because we didn't have Martial. We didn't have what we had in preseason because an injury has taken that away. Ronaldo's not fit. We don't have a number nine. I can get this man the signings. You dirty snake. Get this man the signings that he needs. And it's not just a case of, oh, you lost the game. Oh, let's start screaming for new signings. We need more quality. It's just not, the midfield's not good enough. The midfield is not good enough to compete in this Premier League against Brighton. No offense to Brighton, but by comparison of what we've got coming up, we've got Liverpool coming up in a couple of weeks. We've got City. How are we going to get anywhere near the top four with a midfield that can play like that or can't play like that? McTominay has to sit on the bench. McTominay has to be a squad player for Manchester United. He cannot be starting week in, week out if we are to come anywhere near where we need to get to this season. And it's why De Jong is so crucial. It's why we all wanted our signings done before the first game of the Premier League season there against Brighton. And now it just intensifies the requirements. It makes it more difficult for United if we are going to get signings. I'm seeing we're getting linked with Marco Arnautovic. Jesus, go and get Benjamin Sesko. Boom. Spend the money, man. It is about the money at this point. Just go and fucking do it. Because we've actually genuinely got a manager who has a real system, has real belief in what he's doing. And I've got real belief that he can take us to that. But that there, that was United of last season. That was the exact same shit that we don't want to see any more of. Where was the intensity? Past that first 5 minutes, it just the game went, it went flat. United were never really in the game. Let's be completely honest overall. And it's not an overreaction. It's not knee-jerk. It's just the reality that that squad there is just not good enough to get Ten Hag where he wants this team to be. Scott McTominay cannot be starting week in, week out. And I don't really think that Luke Shaw should be either. Today we saw, because of how bad the performances of Luke Shaw and Diogo Dalo were, we had no threat on the overlaps. Every single time in the preseason that situation emerged, we always had an extra man in space because the overlaps created that opportunity and we were able to play through the press. Today, we didn't have that. We ended up firing in loads of crosses into a box which didn't have a striker. Lo and behold, we didn't get any opportunities. As I said, when Ronaldo came on the pitch, he gave us a bit of a presence there. Ronaldo doesn't even want to be here. I still think he'll be probably our top scorer this season. But I'm just... same old shit, right? Same old Manchester United there. New season, new hopes, new ambitions. Same crap build-up. Same... the players look scared. The players look nervous. There was just a real trepidation about our football from front to back, which we just did not see in preseason. Every time that, as I say, every time sort of Harry Maguire had the ball or Martinez, McTominay kind of went hiding. Fred kind of went hiding. Nobody stood there and played the De Jong role. Give me the ball. Let me start this build up. McTominay ran away. Anytime he had it, it wasn't good enough. Fred, we know that Fred can't be a De Jong alternative. But Ten Hag, I back the idea that Erik Ten Hag, he only wants the players that he wants. But there has to be, I don't know. I don't think I can sit here and support the idea now that if we don't get De Jong, we're just going to build from within. Right there, we saw today what that building from within can do or can't do. And it can't compete in the Premier League. It can't compete against Brighton. That's their first ever win at Old Trafford. And today, it wasn't necessary if the signings were already done. Now, of course, we've got stuck in this De Jong situation and it has to be resolved, man, because without De Jong, I don't know how this system works overall. I really, really don't. I just can't see how this is going to be. Ten Hag's going to coach that into these players. You can't do it against Brighton. Of course, maybe it's just going to be first game of the season, nerves, and you can talk about what you want. But there was a real intensity to our football in pre-season, and we built on it game by game. The patterns and the build-up, it looked like a new United. But that there today, that was the United of last season, just all over again. Same issues, same problems, same lack of personality, lack of lead, lack of anything, lack of any sort of backbone whatsoever. And even when the goal went in 2-1 and Old Trafford was bouncing, we had them on the ropes for like 5 to 6 minutes or so, but we were just firing crosses into the box, aimless crosses. Not what we've done in pre-season. We played differently today. We played crap today. We need more. He needs more if we're going to compete. And you dirty rat, get him the signings that he needs. What's the point in getting a manager like Ten Hag in if you're not going to give him the tools he needs to be successful? United need more quality. Ten Hag needs more quality or results like that. That's not going to be a one-off this season. they're going to keep popping up. Because this team is not good enough to compete with the best in the Premier League. We need more. Simple as that.